Credit to Albion, they deserved the win. For minute one, better team. Deserved it, 100%. No excuses.
Mm-hmm. After a good performance last week, for a man short, what do you put that down to today?
You put pressure on people, see what character's all about. You know, that's what it was today. You've got a chance to go and have a good finish to a season. Albion are different to play for. I've been given a bit of good news on off the back of some horrific news, I may add, so condolences and thoughts are with the family. You know, a real shame, a real loss to Albion Rovers, and you know, a tragic thing to happen, obviously, big Dukesy. But obviously they get the sort of wee footballing bonus with getting 3 points against Clyde, and it'd be light at the end of the tunnel for them, and they looked a hungrier, wounded animal today than us, but we did, you know, rolled up, arrogant. Lack of desire and arrogance for me. No, what can you've not got a divine right to win in a game.
Does that annoy you more, given that the recent game here there was nothing in it really, and it took a late winner?
No, it doesn't annoy me anymore. You've got to win football matches. Every football match is in its own merit, you know, and you play your own part in every game. Well, there's no divine right to single out a partner in the next 3 or 4 games. You get different problems with every game, and we didn't have the answers to the problems that Albion posed us today, and we've come up second best by quite a stretch, to be honest.
It must perplex you when you know what they're capable of, don't you?
I mean, I come in here, the team is second bottom, so does it surprise me? Mm-hmm. No, because it's well within this team to lose games, as they've proven. It's also well within them to win games, as they've proven. So, but am I sitting here shocked, stunned, and struggling to find answers? No, because they're more than capable of losing games of football. They've proven that for July 14th, whenever the season started, unfortunately. And, you know, that's where, unfortunately, we're falling down at the minute. You know, and again, you know, I'll look at it, obviously, and see what I could have done better, which is loads. And then, you know, see what the boys could have done better. So, obviously, that the buck will stop, you know, with the team that we pick, and that's how it will be, you know. So we got it wrong today, and the players then underperformed a bit. But credit, Albion Rovers deserved that today. You know, credit to them. Every one of them ran like it was the last game of football they were going to have. They tackled like it was the last game of football they were going to have, and they, you know, they just showed that real hunger. You know. Well done, Albion Rovers.
Would you have expected to at least create more chances in the game?
I thought we created chances. I thought we had a few things that fell, didn't quite fall the right side is, but I thought we created chances, but we're very flat-footed. We weren't in the front foot at any point today. Balls falling in and around, strikers getting chances, defenders getting to it first. Great defending, poor strike play, bit of both. But listen, it is what it is. As I say, I'm not going to take it away from Albion Rovers today, you know, for saying we were, I think we're poor. That's my opinion on us, but I think credit where credit's due, and we've just got to take this as chance, and we were second best today.
And you spoke of the importance of not letting the season drift away.
Aye, well, it's in danger of doing that at this minute. You know, we're coming into a period now, another hard game next week, and the players are going to have to dust themselves down, you know. We'll see what training numbers are like this week after another harsh defeat. When we came in, people didn't want to train because it was tough. So it's sort of characters, and, you know, this is, we're now in a wee bitty kind of form. Put a wee patch over, sort of up, down, and so now it's about characters, you know, and who's going to sort of pull us by the bootlaces and drag us back into a more even plateau where we can start to build again. Because right now, being up at there at 9-10s and then going down to 2s and 3s isn't acceptable, you know, and it's not going to give you any consistency over the course of the season.
Couple of first half changes, was that one injury, one tactical, Kevin?
Aye, yep, one injury, one tactical.